Ja, hallo und herzlich willkommen zu Planescape Torment. Wir sind noch im Lower Ward und mal gucken, was wir hier noch so anstellen können.
I'm gone.
Zum Beispiel hier mal in den Pawn Shop gucken. Mord, möchtest du mitkommen?
Alright.
Okay, was haben wir hier? Ein Shopper und Mika und Proka. Okay. This rotund woman complete with shrewish eyes and a nasal voice brays out.
Now what have we here? A customer? Do mine eyes spy a customer?
The diminutive man replies, "Of course your eyes spy a customer. They see a customer all the time. Customers on the street. We have no customers. We will never have customers. It is useless and forlorn to hope for." He pauses as his eyes alight on you. "Mika, we have a customer."
That's what I've been saying to you.
She lowers her voice and turns to you.
What can we do for you?
Can you tell me about this area?
I'm sure my husband here will be more than delighted to tell you about the civic fest hall at the brothel. She sniffs. But my tastes run more toward...
Her tastes run toward whatever can make her belly larger. Her taste is entirely in her mouth, and even then she has precious little.
Precious little judgment too, I say, because I allowed your words to sway me away from promising future, and now I'm...
The two of them hurl themselves headlong into pointed bickering. The two of them are in a heated argument. They ignore you entirely as their words slowly fill the air in the shop.
New taunts, all right!
Oh, okay. Hey, Chief, can you believe those two? They could teach me a thing or two. I believe it.
Alright, I'm gone.
Schon mal hier sind und die abgelenkt sind,
done.
Da können wir ja mal hier mal.
Locked. I'm gone.
Anna? Ihr streitet euch schön weiter, ne? Wir gucken hier einfach mal.
Got it. Why not?
Und habt ihr was gemerkt? Okay, er geht schon wieder. Also offensichtlich ist das mit dem. Shop betreiben, müssen die noch ein bisschen üben. Aber, na gut, man kann nicht alles können. So, was haben wir denn jetzt hier? Was war das? Charm of Infinite Recall. Okay. Clip Copper, da hatten wir doch schon was von. Ah ne, das habe ich schon verkauft. Okay. Mhm. Kann Mord eigentlich... Ne, kann er nicht. Keine Ohrringe tragen. Stimmt, hat er auch keine Ohren mehr. Ich bin ja blöd. Mhm. So. Gut. Wo können wir da nochmal hin? Marketplace waren wir schon, Wrecked House waren wir schon, Coffin Maker waren wir noch nicht. The strange building appears to be a Coffin Maker's shop. The sign about the door has the slogan Engineered for Eternity clearly written upon it.
Alright. Ja, gut.
Dann schauen wir mal. Oh Gott, wie kommen wir da hin? Da. Aha. So, da gucken wir uns erstmal um hier. So eine ganze Menge.
Alright.
Bandages. Copper. Don't mind us. Silver Bracelet. Okay, das war ja schon mal nicht schlecht. Okay, so, wen haben wir hier? Dimtree und... Schön, was? Ihr Hamris, ihr unterhaltet euch gerade? Wollt ihr nochmal was sagen? Ja, schauen wir mal. Sure, quiet one today. Mm-hmm. You see a tall, slender man with a glassy-eyed expression. He seems engrossed in some tale that the shopkeeper is relating. Occasionally he nods his head, but makes no comments of his own. Greetings. The man turns slightly at your greeting, just enough to acknowledge your presence. You notice that he is a little pale of complexion and rather gaunt-looking. He is giving you a blank stare. The shopkeeper does not seem to notice any of this and continues with a stream of useless prattle. Are you all right? The man continues to stare at you and slowly nods. You wait for any further response, but he says nothing, only stares. You are about to turn away in frustration when you think you notice a strange musty odor about the man. Step closer and sniff. You lean in and sniff at the man, unsure what you'll find. As you do, a musty odor fills your senses, an odor you recognize from your time in the mortuary. It is the smell of dead. It is the smell of dead flesh, preserved by magic. You are a zombie, aren't you? This is a schöne Anrede. The creature continues to stare at you blankly, slowly, as if with great effort he begins to reply to you. Only your speak with dead power makes him understandable. Yes, I am Dimtree. Why are you here, Dimtree? Dimtree slowly glances at the shopkeeper and makes a feeble gesture toward him. Seeing this as a sign of interest, the shopkeeper redoubles his efforts in telling whatever tale he is relating to the poor creature. Dimtree looks at you again.
Hemorrhous, he talks. Hemorrhous never stops. Wanders town. Annoys master. Annoys everyone. Master create Dimtree. Tells Dimtree talk Hemorrhous. Now Hemorrhous stay in shop. Master happy, town happy, Dimtree sad.
Das ist aber auch gemein. Ja, der hat offensichtlich alle Welt so genervt, dass sie ihm jetzt hier einen Gesprächspartner reingestellt haben. Das ist gut für die Welt, allerdings schlecht für den Gesprächspartner, das sehe ich ein. Is there anything I can do to help you, Dimtree? Ihn umbringen? The creature pauses, then resumes his slow speech with you. You can almost detect a pleading tone in his voice.
Yes, find master. Sebastian. Ask him release me, please.
He turns his attention to Hemorrhous momentarily.
Please.
Why don't I just put you out of your misery? This is ja... Okay, farewell. Machen wir mal. Dann sprechen wir erstmal mit dir. Was hast du denn zu erzählen hier? You see a rugged-looking, square-jawed man. He turns to you with a wide smile.
How are you, Cutter? Good day to you. Good day indeed.
He squints at you for a second and juts his hand out to shake yours. Shake his hand. Greetings.
Oh, God.
Hemorrhous at your service, member of the Ammonium and the fashioner of fine coffins for the recently departed. I think I know you, do I not? Let me see if I can place it. He pauses to think for a moment. Sharp with names I was in Ammonium. Let me tell you, knew everyone in the entire ward. My name is Adan.
He snaps his finger. Of course, Adan! I knew I recognized you.
Anyway, you require my services. He studies you, then smiles, seeing the opportunity for a joke at your expense.
It seems to me, sir, that you are one in desperate need of a coffin, and soon.
He seems pleased with his wit.
I have some questions.
He nods at you. Ask away.
Okay. I hear father died. Can you tell me what happened? Was?
Haben wir das gehört? Balla.
Who's your friend here?
He glances at the customer.
Dimtree?
He shrugs, like he hadn't considered the fellow before.
Quiet, doesn't say much, do you, Dimtree?
Dimtree doesn't respond, but simply gives the same blank expression. A few seconds later he nods.
Hemorrhous shrugs, turns back to you.
Wandered in one day a few weeks back, been a regular ever since. He hasn't bought anything, but he doesn't cause any trouble, so I let him stay.
Seems harmless enough.
You see, when I was serving the Ammonium, part of our work was to take people under our wing, give them a little shelter from the chaos of the streets, get them spruced up. You know that he's a zombie, don't you? He frowns, glances at Dimtree, then back at you. What nonsense are you rattling on about? Dimtree's no zombie. Sure, he may be quiet and doesn't move much, but it's just because he's a good listener. Punch Dimtree. Look, he's a zombie. Okay, never mind. What can you tell me about this ward? Yes, the lower ward. He leans forward as if explaining something to a small child. You know, it's little known to most newcomers and even people in the ward. Most people think that this ward gets its name simply because it's not as prestigious as some of the other wards, but that's not it at all. Not at all. Do you know where the name comes from? From all the lower plane portals? He nods, though he seems a little disappointed that you know. Yes, indeed. These portals to the lower planes are actually the reason for the smog in the skies here. He glances upward, as if imagining a sky above your heads. But I'm sure you're already aware of the conditions that plague the ward. Can you tell me of the city of Sigil? Sigil is the city at the center of all things, or so many believe. It is the city of doors. There are literally thousands of portals here. It is home to the Lady of Pain herself. He shrugs. Sigil is a topic that can fill volumes and volumes of volumes. Tell me about the Lady of Pain. The Lady of Pain. Hemrys leans in and drops his voice slightly. One of the multiverse's greatest mysteries, everyone will agree. I think she's proved beyond doubt. I think she's proved beyond that shadow that females are the most dangerous creatures in the multiverse. Anna, möchtest du dazu was sagen? Oder das soll ich stehen lassen? Females are the most dangerous creatures in the multiverse. Go on. Some say she's a goddess, a power that's made Sigil her home. She breaks the laws of every power I've encountered. Powers need worshippers. Gives them their power, but the lady doesn't like to be worshipped. People who do end up in her shadow, their flesh torn apart by invisible blades. Now, I've seen some horrible things in my life, things that would make another man's knees go weak and make him lose control of his vitals. Doesn't even compare to seeing one of the lady's victims. Interesting. What else can you tell me? Next is, she don't take to people who try and play God in Sigil. See, you may not know this, but first off, no powers can enter Sigil. Not Zeus, not Ra, no one. Word is that the lady's presence somehow keeps them out. Can't get in, not a one, and that twists their stems like you wouldn't believe. Sigil's such a sweet fruit that anyone would want to pluck. That the other powers are always looking for some way into Sigil. They haven't succeeded. Well, it goes beyond that. Not only does the lady keep them out, she keeps anybody inside the city from harming it. Certainly she has help from our faction, the Harmonium, since we like order. But every once in a while a foolish basher takes it into their head to start fighting on the streets of the city, maybe decide to kill a few Dabos, brew up some chaos, or start casting mass destruction spells. Not a good thing. Makes the lady upset. Doesn't like to see her city hurt. She'll kill you. Or mace you for doing such. Mace you? You haven't heard of the mazes, he looks at you condescendingly. You're green. The lady's got extra-dimensional prisons she can place special offenders in. You see, she takes little bits of Sigil, shapes them into mazes, then cuts them off from Sigil. You'll be walking home one night or be stepping through an archway near your home, then suddenly everything changes. You won't be in the same place you remember. You'll be trapped. Chant is, there's one way to get out of each maze, but you'll be dead and gone before you tumble onto the dark of how to escape. I hear your father died. Can you tell me what happened? He frowns at you. Well, he disappeared some time ago, so I can only assume that he is dead. Where did you hear this? I don't recall. You say he disappeared? He nods. Oh yes, many, many years ago. My father was a talented stonemason, and he did not only construct sarcophagi... guy, whatever, but he was also quite skilled in tomb design. Moment mal, hat er uns vielleicht geholfen? People from across Sigil, the room begins to fade around you as a memory tugs at your consciousness.
relax and try
updated to
updated
my journal.
Mm-hmm. You find yourself standing in this very shop, talking with an older man, while a child sits in the corner and plays. Tatsächlich. Da hat er unser Tun gebaut. Wahnsinn. On the counter between you and the shopkeeper is a set of plans. He seems to be explaining some intricacies with the construction of a tomb. Your vision fades as you try to examine the details of the plans. When your sight returns, you are standing in a cavern in front of a tomb. Above the entry, you see the slogan, Engineered for Eternity, clearly carved in the stone. The shopkeeper is standing next to you, a broad smile on his face. He gestures to you and begins to walk into the tomb. You quickly match his pace from behind and draw your blade. You find yourself back in Henry's shop. He's looking at you with some concern. Okay, wir haben seinen Vater ermordet. Toll. Toll, toll. Nein, ja gut, keine Zeugen, ne? Logisch. Hat unser Tomb gebaut und darf natürlich keiner erfahren, wie das Design ist. Naja. Murderous bastard. You find it, tell me what happened to your father. He simply vanished one day, leaving most of his commissions unfinished. Most embarrassing. Took a long while to get out of the debt, because by his disappearance, and to an extent, I am still settling various accounts. Still, I have a certain aptitude for the work, and he sighs lightly and gets a faraway look in his eyes. I'm sorry, I was just thinking. My father's disappearance was the reason I joined the Harmonium and left it later on. At first, I had a burning desire to find out what happened to him. Later, I felt a certain obligation to continue his life's work. I never found the answers I sought. It was quite the mystery as to what happened. His voice fades to silence. Did your father keep any of the plans for the tombs he built? Yes, he did. After I came of age and inherited the business, I went through all of his records. They were quite extensive. Why do you ask? If I describe a tomb to you, could you tell me if it was your father's work? He frowns in thought, then shrugs. I can but try. My ammonium training has blessed me with a sharp memory. I should be able to recognize my father's work if you gave me enough details. He looks at you expectingly. Describe the tomb from your memory. He thinks for some time. There's little doubt that the tomb you describe is my father's work. The slogan you mentioned has been the family trademark for several generations. He pauses and gives you a strange look. This tomb, where is it located? Describe the location. Describe the location in detail, surprising yourself with the knowledge you have of the area. Ach, vielleicht doch nicht unseres. Vielleicht doch noch ein anderes. Hamrius watches you with a concerned look. Odd. I don't recall anything in the family records that would have permitted him to construct a tomb there. The Dustmen are very careful about building rights and real estate, especially beneath the streets of Sigil. Das ist tatsächlich noch ein anderes, hm? Then you recognize the location. He nods enthusiastically. Oh yes, sounds like the drowned... Nee, ist doch unseres. Sounds like the drowned nation catacombs to me. Pauses. I've never been there myself, but I've heard the area described many a time in my years in the Harmonium. I need to know if your father kept the plans for the tomb. Yes, the warehouse where I store my goods handles my business documents as well. Anyway, they are having internal problems of some sort. New management or some such nonsense. I haven't been able to replenish my stock of late, and I doubt I could retrieve any paperwork from them either. He frowns. The Harmonium would never let things get so out of hand as to cause distrust to its customers. His voice fades away as he thinks, and then he looks at you. Perhaps you would look into the matter for me? The warehouse. Yes, the warehouse is having some internal problems of some sort, whatever that means. I can't get any stock from them until the matter's cleared up. The Harmonium, bla bla. I guess I don't have a choice if I want the plans.
Updated my journal.
He smiles broadly. Excellent. If you deal with this issue satisfactorily, you may have your plans for free. He gets that lecture look on his face again. That may not seem like sufficient payment, but let me tell you about the difficulty involved in creating those plans. No, thank you. I'll just get started on this right away. Okay, okay, okay. Mal gucken, was wir darüber rausfinden können. Und Zu Sebastian. Dann. Müssen wir. Ich hasse das. Ne, geht mal weg da. Blockiert er hier den Cursor? Geht ja nicht hier.
I'm gone.
Zu Sebastian müssen wir ja auch. Und der war hier. Gehen wir erstmal hier hin. Jawohl, gehen wir erstmal. Machen wir lieber vielleicht erstmal das, nicht, dass dann, wenn Dimtree abhaut, dass der dann irgendwie nicht mehr uns helfen will. Machen wir erstmal das hier. Okay. So, und jetzt wieder. Ah, können auch von hier mit dir sprechen, ist ja sehr gut. Twice welcome to the vaults of the ninth world. How may I serve you on this fine day, civilian? I'd like to respond and claim something. I was told that I could retrieve some plans for a tomb here. Plans for a tomb? You don't look dead, sir. Not that it's any of my business if you are. Here are your plans, sir. Can I get you anything else? No. Farewell. Yeah, I bet. Das ist doch gar nicht so schwierig. Wo sind jetzt diese Management-Problems? Ich verstehe das nicht. Das habe ich übrigens, glaube ich, nie verstanden, warum die da immer von irgendwelchen Management-Problems reden und dass man im Warehouse nichts bekommen könnte. Weil, ich meine, offensichtlich geht das ja. Vielleicht ist das was, dass es nicht in die finale Version geschafft hat, oder ich übersehe hier einfach das vollständig. Ja, ist ja auch egal, ist ja nicht so wichtig, ist ja nur das Warehouse. Wo war jetzt der Eingang hier? So. Good day again, Cutter. Did you get the plans you were looking for? Yes, I've dealt with the situation at the warehouse. Ja, wir haben einfach nach ihnen gefragt and got the tomb plans. Vielleicht war das noch irgendwie eine zusätzliche Sidequest, die es da gegeben hätte. Aber, ey, was
updated my journal.
Das ist auf jeden Fall, war schon immer etwas seltsam. He smiles and nods. Well done, Cutter. As I said, you may keep whatever you recovered from the warehouse as your reward. Thank you for your help. Okay. So, dann wollen wir mal gucken. These are the plans of a custom-made tomb. Stenciled proudly across the top edge, otherwise engineered for eternity. Speichern wir mal. Weil das können wir ja benutzen. The plans would make more sense if you were in the tomb itself. You could then make direct comparisons between the plans and how they were implemented. Okay, also wir müssen irgendwie nochmal zurück ins Tomb und mit den Plänen in der Hand uns das nochmal angucken. Vielleicht gibt es da noch irgendwelche Secret Rooms oder so. Okay. So, jetzt müssen wir uns noch, jetzt noch zu Sebastian hier. Wo bist du denn?
Alright, I'm gone.
So. Sebastian smiles at you. Good day, Ketta. How am I? Never mind, Sebastian. Farewell. Was soll das? Aha, scheint die Quest gar nicht. Wir haben die Quest gar nicht bekommen. Okay, habe ich wohl offensichtlich einmal zu früh Farewell geklickt. Also nochmal zu Dimtree. Ist das Wrecked House? Hier wollen wir hin. Ah, Gottes. So. Nochmal Dimtree. You help, please? Yes, I help you.
Updated my journal.
Ah, jetzt. Danke. Okay. Jetzt nochmal.
Alright.
Okay, Kumpel. Können wir jetzt mit dir reden? Good day, Cutter. How may I help you? Actually, I want to talk to you about Dimtree. He stares at you for a moment and then sighs. What about Dimtree, Cutter? He wants to be released. I just wanted to compliment you on a job well done. he wants to be released from his curse. He gives you a surprised look and then waves you off. I find it hard to believe, Cutter. Dimtree doesn't have the mental power to desire anything. He frowns for a moment. Did that idiot Hamrius put you up to this? Think about it, Sebastian. Hamrius doesn't know Dimtree is a zombie, let alone who created him, right? He sighs and seems to be deep in thought. Yes, you're right, of course. Hamrius could not have sent you. I guess poor Dimtree is more aware than I intended. A pox on me for my stupidity. So will you release him? He looks at you for a moment with conflicting emotions crossing his face. He sighs and throws his arms up in exasperation. I cannot, sorry. He gives you a pleading look. I want to, mind you, but I cannot. I fulfilled the contract by creating Dimtree, and I cannot break it, right or wrong. I am a man of my word. My reputation demands it. I understand your dilemma and agree with you. Really don't give a rat's ass? Nah. I understand your dilemma and agree with you. Could I release him instead? That would be difficult. He turns and begins to look through a nearby box. After a moment, he removes a book which he sets down in front of you. First, you'd have to have some magical aptitude. Second, you'd have to be able to properly speak the words you find on page 23 of this book. Last, you'd have to touch Dimtree just as you feel the power of the words culminate within you. He turns his back on you and rummages throughout another box. I couldn't allow you to read that book, however. It'd be tantamount to my breaking my word through the actions of another. He continues poking through the box, ignoring you. Ja, das gute alte Prinzip. Aber ich kann dich natürlich nicht hindern, es dir durchzulesen, während ich gerade aus Versehen nicht aufpasse.
Read the book and leave. My journal.
Gut.
Alright.
So, das müssten wir jetzt ja wissen. Was sagt das Journal dazu? I learned the incantation, I need to free Dimtree the zombies. I was allowed me to learn it from a book, although he pretended not to notice that. Ja.
Done.
So. Okay, Dimtree. Dimtree turns to face you slightly as you approach. You can feel a sense of expectation in the air about him. You find master? Dimtree release? Yes, Dimtree, I know how to release you now. Dimtree turns to face you and gestures towards you. Please, friend, speak the words Sebastian taught you. Der hat mir doch keine beigebracht, Spiel. Das durfte er doch nicht. Das habe ich doch selber gelernt. You pause to gather your thoughts and then carefully speak the words Sebastian taught you. Schon wieder. You then reach out and touch Dimtree lightly on the forehead. Rest well, Dimtree.
Updated my journal.
With a sigh, the zombie collapses at your feet. You think you hear a fleeting thank you, friend, as he falls to the ground. Leave.
Done.
Vorher nehmen wir ihm natürlich noch seine Wertsachen weg und dann hauen wir mal ganz schnell ab. Tut uns leid um den Customer. Okay. It's finally addressed. Okay. I cast the spell. He's now at peace and no longer needs to listen to Aaron's prattle. Ja gut, allerdings der Rest von Ziegel wird mich jetzt wahrscheinlich hassen, weil er jetzt wieder aus seinem Laden rausgeht und mit anderen Leuten quatscht. Naja, gut. Kann ich alles haben. So, okay. Dann würde ich sagen, war's das für dieses Video. Und dann sehen wir uns beim nächsten Mal wieder im Lower Ward. Und ich denke, dann gehen wir mal zum Siege Tower. Okay, also, bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss.